Hello friends, welcome to the first lecture of Vector Algebra presented by me, Shirshendu Mitra, Research Scholar of Indian Institute of Technology, Guwahati. So if you have any queries, you can contact me in this mail IDs given here. So today we will be learning about vector. The basic things we will be covering today are definition of vector, vector summation, vector multiplication, and the types of vector multiplications possible and their significance. Significance means physical significances. So let us start with the definition of vector. So in physics we encounter two types of quantities, and those are scalar quantities and vector quantities. And what is a scalar quantity? The things which do not have any direction and only it has a magnitude, that is called scalar quantity. And the examples of scalar quantities maybe say mass, density, volume, all these things are scalar quantity because these things only has some magnitude and they do not have any direction. Now the things which have directions are treated as vector quantity, and those are for example velocity, displacement, force, etc., etc. And why velocity is a vector? If I say you suppose whenever you are talking about a bike is moving, then you need to tell in which direction the bike is moving and with what magnitude of speed it is moving. So say when I am telling that a bike is moving in the direction in each direction with a velocity of 5 km/h. So we are saying that the magnitude with which the car is or the bike is moving, and as well the which direction it is moving. So if I do not tell you in which direction the bike is moving, then you do not have any idea about the direction, but you have the idea of 5 km/h. So this 5 km/h is the magnitude and the east is the direction. So combinedly these two things form a vector quantity, and same for force also. Whenever you are putting a force on certain objects, either you are trying to move the object and it basically moves, or it tries to move, that is the force. The direction in which you are putting the force, it is trying to move in that direction only. So that is why direction becomes important in certain quantities, and those quantities are called vector quantities. So now I will be going to some calculations of vector directly. Suppose I have a vector A and vector B. So vector A is given by a1i plus a2j plus a3k. Now all of you know that this I, j, k are representing the unit vectors associated with the coordinates, and the coordinate system which we have taken for this particular thing is Cartesian coordinate systems, where I is the unit vector along x direction, j is the unit vector along y direction, and k is the unit vector along z direction. And you can see some a1, a2 and a3, these coefficients are associated with this I, j and k unit vectors. So these coefficients basically represent the components or magnitude of the components of a1, a2 and a3, and these components a1 is in the x direction, a2 is in the y direction, and a3 is in z direction. So this is a summation of the components. Now this is not a normal summation, this is called vector summation, and it is different from the normal summation, because if we add 2 plus 3 it gives me 5 in scalar algebra. But here we'll show you that it is somewhat different from the scalar algebra. So the thing which you need to know is the vector algebra is different from the scalar algebra. Okay, whatever. Now we have a similar kind of vector B here. B is again equal to B1i, B2j plus B3k. Now the first operation which I will show you is that if I want to add A plus B, so that would be a vector addition. So A plus B that would be equal to, so you the rule is you can only add with the same components. That means x component can be added with x component of other vector, similarly y and j component. Now, so the component in the x direction would be, after the summation, a1 plus a2, the unit vector remains same, I represent unit vector along x direction, plus in the other in the y direction it becomes a2 plus b2, sorry, this one would be a1 plus b1 because along x component it was b1. So the unit vector associated would be j, plus in the z direction it would be a3 plus b3, similarly k. So this is the summation. And similarly, if I negate a minus b, a is again the same vector, a minus b, so everything would be same, only instead of summation we have to do subtraction. So a1 minus b1, a2 minus b2, and a3 minus b3 would be the components along x, y and z directions respectively. So this is a simple thing, everybody can do this summation and subtraction, but the thing which is important here that I will tell you, any vector, it has two things, one is its magnitude and another is its direction. So the magnitude of any vector, if it is if it is represented by this a1i plus a2j plus a3k, then the magnitude would be, I'll tell you, so the mod of a, or magnitude of a, I represent it by, I'm not representing it by bold, normal a means my magnitude and bold a means vector. So a is nothing but root over of a1 square plus a2 square plus a3 square. So similarly you can write the magnitude of b, that would be equal to, it would be same, only a1 instead of a1, b1 square plus b2 square plus c2 square. b1, b2 and b3, it would be b3 square, yeah. So here you can see, now we have already calculated the magnitude of A. Now any vector can be represented, see A is a vector that is that can be equated to magnitude of the same multiplied by unit vector, and that unit vector we can represent by N. Say N is the unit vector, so we represent any vector in bold. So if I give you any vector, you can easily calculate the unit vector associated with that particular vector, and that would be equal to, from this equation you can see, that would be equal to modulus of A, sorry, vector A by modulus of A. So n cap would be equal to vector A by this modulus. So So up to this point, the things which we learnt are what is vector and how can we represent a vector, and what how to do the sum of two vectors and subtraction of two vectors, and what is magnitude of the vector and the unit vector associated with a particular vector. So after that, we will directly go to vector multiplication. So vector, in vector multiplication we have two types of multiplication, I will tell you, and those are dot product and cross product. In dot product, you can write it down, say we have dot product of vector, second thing is cross product, cross product of vectors. Now whenever you are doing a dot product of two vectors, you will get a scalar quantity, scalar quantity and if you do cross product, you will get a vector quantity. That is why dot product is also called scalar product and the cross product is called vector product, because it gives a vector. That is why it's called vector product, nothing else. Now how to do this dot product and cross product, that we'll show. I can delete it now. So now I'll do A dot B. So dot, we can represent it by this, yeah. A dot B would be equal to, if the vectors are represented in this form, then I will tell you in whenever you are doing A dot B, so the similar components will get multiplied, as we did in the case of summation. The similar components were getting sum of, here the similar components like A1 and B1 will get multiplied. So A1 B1 I, and one more thing, whenever you are doing I dot I, it would become 1. So do not write any I, and as I told you earlier, dot product gives you a scalar quantity, so in there would be no ijk associated with, because I, if there is any ijk, that means it's a vector quantity. So you just do the component multiplications only, so this becomes A dot B. Now this thing you can do other, in other process also. Suppose you have to do A dot B. A dot B is again equal to mod of A into mod of B, that means mod A into mod B into cos theta, where cos theta, where theta is the angle between vectors A and B vectors. Now from this equation you know that A dot B again is equal to A1 B1 plus A2 B2 plus A3 B3. If I replace it, then I end up with a new equation which looks like this. Now from this equation we can easily calculate the value of cos theta, and that would be something like So cos theta becomes A1 B1 plus A2 B2 plus A3 B3 by AB. So from this equation one can easily calculate theta. and theta would be equal to cos inverse of the right hand term. It would be cos inverse of this entire quantity. So this is how one calculates dot product, and also one can calculate the angle between two vector quantities. Now the thing is, if the theta is 90 degree, then what happens? We all know that cos theta, cos 90 degree is equal to 0. So if theta is 90 degree, then A dot B becomes 0, because A B into 0 means 0. So the thing is, if two vectors are in perpendicular, then their dot product is 0, or else we can say, to check whether the vectors are orthogonal or not, you have to do dot product, and if the answer comes 0, then you can say the vectors are mutually perpendicular or orthogonal. All the things are synonymous: perpendicular, orthogonal, all the things are same. And if the vectors are not in 90 degree, but they make in some other angle, then you can calculate the angle from this equation. If I give you the numerical values of a1, b1, a2, b2, a3, b3 and all, then you can easily calculate ab, and a is, I already told you, a equal to square root of a1 square plus a2 square plus a3 square, and b is again equal to square root of b1 square plus b2 square plus b3 square. So one can easily calculate a, b, and at the same time this thing. So theta can easily be calculated from these equations. So these were all about the dot product. Now we come to the cross product. Now cross product of two vectors, as I told you earlier, it will give another vector, and that would be, I'll show you, A cross B. That means determinant of I J K, all are unit vectors, A1, A2, A3 by B1, B2, B3, if I align it properly, yeah, it looks something like this. So determinant of A cross B equal to determinant of IJK A1, A2, A3, B1, B2, B3. If one calculates this IJK would be in bold, because those are vector quantity, and the representation would be all the vector quantities will be giving in bold. Okay, so if I calculate the value of the determinant, it comes I multiplied by, when you are calculating I, so you cover these two line, so it would be A2 B3 minus A3 B2, A2 B3 minus A3 B2. We all know plus minus plus, like this it goes. So minus J whenever you are doing minus J, so again you cover these two lines, so this into this minus that into that, so A1 B3 minus B1 A3. Plus K (clears whenever you are doing with k, so this row and that column will be covered, and it would be a1 b2 minus a2 b1 a1 b2 minus a2 b1. So this is the cross product. So you can see here, after the cross product, the answer whatever you are getting is associated with I, j and k, and it means that the product is again a vector. Now I'll give you some examples where we encounter this cross product in some physical quantities, like whenever we are talking about angular velocities, then angular velocity is what, say omega represents the angular velocity, and angular velocity is given by velocity vector into velocity vector cross of position vector. If velocity vector is v cross position vector, say r, all these things will be in bold because we are representing vector in bold. So here you can see omega is a vector. Yeah, omega is a vector, and that is multiplication of two other vector, and this type of multiplication is called cross product. I'll give you one more example, that is moment represented by tau. Moment is again equal to r cross f, where r is the position vector with respect to some zero coordinate, r cross f, where f is the linear force, say r cross f. So those are the examples where we encounter cross products, and this is the way how we do cross products. So if I give you two vectors, so now you can easily do the cross product. Now the significance of cross product is the physical quantities after getting multiplied by two vectors, if it gives another vector, and then we will say the vector is cross product of the vector is coming after the cross product of two vectors. Now say I can represent this cross product in some other way also. Say A cross B is nothing but equal to mod A mod into mod B into sine theta. Previously it was cos theta, but here in cross product it is sine theta, where theta is the angle between two vectors. But this is not the case, something would also be there, and that is a unit vector, because as I told you earlier, whenever we are doing cross product we will get a vector quantity. So you can see here this AB sin theta is a scalar, so there should be a vector in order to make the product a vector. Yeah, so one thing you should remember here, whenever you are doing a cross product, so you are getting another vector, and that vector will always be mutually perpendicular to both the vectors you have multiplied. What does it mean? If this A is in x direction and B is in y direction, then it is obvious that n would be in the z direction, or this product would be in the z direction. And one can easily calculate n, and if you are asked to calculate unit vector perpendicular to two vectors given, then you can easily calculate from this equation. Yeah, unit vector perpendicular to two vectors given would be equal to a cross b by a b sin theta. Now again, a b sin theta is nothing but mod of a cross b. So even if you are not given with the angle theta, you can calculate the unit vector perpendicular to the perpendicular to both the vectors given here. So modulus of, or I can write like this, mod of a cross b. So that is how one can calculate unit vector perpendicular to the vector. So one thing, one more thing I should mention here, whenever we are doing a cross b, it is not exactly equal to b cross a, and the relation between a cross b and b cross e is b cross a is something like this. A cross b is exactly equal to negative of b cross a. Yeah, what does it mean? Suppose A is acting in the x direction and B is acting in the y direction, and that is I am taking x and y in the clockwise direction. So then the product A cross B will act in the z direction, and that would be in the positive x direction, z direction. But if I take a product of B cross A, then it would act in the negative z direction. So the direction of the product would be exactly in the opposite directions, and that is the significance of the cross product. So today up to this